If I am saying you guys, then believe me, I have used each and every editing apps from Play Store. So trust me on this, these are the best apps I'm going to give in this video. Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. If you guys are new here, then welcome. As you guys requested, I am making this video and this video is all about my editing style, what I do with my photos after taking those photos before uploading anywhere else. So if you guys want to know how I edit, then watch till the end. But before starting this video, make sure to subscribe my channel, hit that red subscribe button, and don't forget to tap the bell notification beside that. And if you guys like this video, please hit the like button. So without wasting much time, let's get started with the video. For those who are new to my channel, I would recommend to watch this video right here, which is all about how I take my Instagram pictures at home myself without any photographer and without any help. But don't skip this video right now. So I generally edit all my pictures in my phone, which is quite easier. So I transfer all the pictures from my camera to my mobile phone. So let's jump right into my phone screen now. So these are the apps that I generally use to edit my pictures. So for today, I am going to open Lightroom first and I'm going to import my photos that I am going to edit today. So these are my 4 photos that I'm going to edit today, and I have taken some bright and dark photos as well. So first of all, I'm going to edit this brighter photo, and the first step I'm going to do is to crop the photo. So you need to find the right framing of the photo you want to edit. And for that, you need to crop the photo, and you can also rotate the photo here. So I'm going to do that for this photo. So here my cropping is done, and now I will move forward to light option. As you can see here, so many options are there. I will change the exposure first, and this will change your brightness or darkness of the photo. So I'm going to do that, and this much is fine. Now I'm going to change the contrast. So the main thing is you need to see what looks good on the picture. You need to play around with all the options given on there. So I'm going to change highlight as well. So for the bright picture, highlight should be less. Now for shadow also, I'll keep it around this much. Now play around with blacks and whites, which will change the black color of the picture and the white color as well. As I am done with that, now move forward to color. In here, you can change the tone of the photo by changing the temperature. Just play with it, and I'm not going to do that. You can also change the tint here. I'm going to change that a little bit. Now move downwards. Here you can change vibrance of the picture, play around with it. You can also change saturation here, but I'm going to keep it as 0. So moving forward to mix, here is the fun part. Here you can change each and every color individually. So I'm going to start with the red color first. As you can see how it is changing only the red color here. So for every color, here are 3 options you can change, that is hue, saturation and luminance. So you need to play around with all the options. Now one thing, keep it in mind that orange and yellow color generally changes your skin color. So don't change it if it is not needed. So for green color, here as green color is not there, so it is not affecting much. Now let's move on to dark blue. As you can see, the sky color is changing. So by decreasing the luminance here,
the sky color has changed. So you need to play around with all the colors given there. So at last, as pink and purple color is not there, so I'm not going to change that. So the next option is effects, so I am going to play around with that. So here you can change texture, clarity as well. Play with the dehaze option also. Dehaze will decrease or increase the effects that you are using for the picture. You can find more options down below. You can add grain also in the picture. Now move over to sharpening option. You can sharpen here. I will do that a little bit as it will give details to the picture. And done. Now I will save it from here and I will edit it more. Now let's open Snapseed and I will import the same photo here. So for your reference, I have given all the links in my description below. You can check it out and you can also download these apps whichever I am using. So here you need to go to Tools and let's select the selective option first. In this option, you can select each and every part of the photo, whichever you want to change. As you can see, I am holding onto my face and it will change only the face area. And here you can change brightness, contrast, saturation and sharpness as well. So I'm going to select each and every area of the picture and I'm going to change whichever I feel like changing. And done. This is before and after, you can see by pressing the photo. Now I will give some grain to the photo. Here you can also change the style of the photo. And that's it, done. Just save it from here and upload it anywhere. So just like this photo, I will edit these other photos also in a super speed mode. And I am going to follow the same steps that I did in the last photo. So just follow my steps. After editing here in Lightroom, I will move this image in Snapseed also, and I am going to spot hill that image in Snapseed. I am going to remove all the spots from my face that I have and it will be flawless after the spot healing tool. So this, you can also do this in Snapseed. And done. This is the final image and I'll export it. So for this image, after editing in Lightroom, I will directly open this image in another app that is Coloro, and this is only for presets that I am going to use in this image also. As you can see here, so many presets are there, but not all the presets are free, so you have to pay for it. But I am going to use the free presets. So I am going to import the image first. My favorite preset is KO03 and I will give that preset in this picture also. And I will adjust a little bit the brightness, the sharpness and contrast also. And that's it. So these are the apps that I use generally. So for this last image, I am going to use only the Lightroom app. And trust me guys, this is the only app that you need to edit your each and every photo and you are totally sorted. And trust me guys, you don't have to use any other app after this Lightroom if you don't want to, but I do for my own satisfaction. But you can use only one app to edit your pictures. As you can see, you can change all the colors individually. So here are the four pictures that I edited today, and here are the final images. So this is the photo before it editing, and this is the after. So this is the raw one, and this one is after. This is the before picture, and again this is the after picture. So here is the last picture, and this is the final one.
So this is it guys, that's how I edit my every pictures. If you like my editing style, then please let me know in the comment section below. And if you use any other app for your pictures and which is better than this apps, then also please let me know. I would be happy to know that. And you can also give me any suggestions in the comment section below, and also hit the like button, and don't forget to subscribe my channel also. And I will see you in my next video. Till then, bye bye.